Hello children, welcome to the new session of 2021. Now I am your maths teacher and my name is Anupam Tiwari. Now today we are going to start the new topic, and the topic is negative number and the integers. Now before starting the topic integers, first we should concentrate or have a quick review of the number system. Since the integer is comprised from the group of numbers and there are a variety of numbers, so let us start with the number system. Here, since we are having only up till integer portion, we will be covering three parts of number system. What is the first part? We are dividing the number system into three parts. The first part is natural number. The second part is whole number. And the third part is the directed or the integers. Now, how we can define the natural number? So, whenever we are asking you to talk about the number, whatever number is coming in your mind means any number, yeah, all counting numbers are known as the natural number. So, the example of natural number is 1, 2, 3 and up to infinity. Now, next comes the whole number. So, what are the criteria? Whole number is 0 plus natural number. It means that it is one member more than the set of natural number. What is this member? This member is 0. So, how can we again define it as whole number? The whole number can be defined as 0 when included in the set of natural numbers gives the whole number. So, when you are taking the example of whole number, how can you give the example of whole number? Whole number starts from 0, 1, 2, 3 and continue up till infinity. Further, when you are talking about the integers. Now, before starting the integers, I would like to introduce one new number in this. See, here we have seen that natural number are 1, 2, 3, 4 up till infinity. Whole number is a set including 0 plus all the natural number. But whenever we are taking the day-to-day life example, it is not always possible that always we are getting the number as positive. Supposing we want to subtract a bigger number from a smaller number, then what is the resultant? The resultant is coming as a negative number. So here, before introducing the topic of integers, I would like to introduce the new number, which is the negative number. So, all the numbers which are coming to the right hand side of the 0 are the set of positive numbers. So, where do these negative numbers will come? These negative numbers are coming on the left hand side of zeros. As in the number system, we are writing 1, 2, 3, 4 up to infinity. Similarly, the negative numbers are written from the negative side. They are written as minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and this continues up till minus infinity. Now comes the bigger set of number. What is this bigger set of number? This bigger set of number is that set which include the negative, the whole number and the natural number. So, natural number include the positive, whole number include the zero, and the integers is the set of those numbers which includes the negative, the positive and the zero. So how can you define? All negative numbers, zero and the positive numbers combine to form the set of integers. So how can we write the example of an integers? So the example of integer is minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2 and so on. Now, after understanding the concept of integers, what is the major problem which is coming in your mind? The major problem which is coming in your mind is, how will you represent these integers on the number line? So now, let us understand that how we have to explain number line.
Now here, see. Here, I have made the number line for you. Zero is the reference point of the number. On the right hand side of the zero, all the integers which are occurring are known as the positive integers. Since zero is the reference point, on the left hand side, whatever integers are coming are the negative integers. Now, as we can easily see that when we are considering the positive integers and the negative integers, the number which is coming to the right of the number is greater than the number which is coming to the left of the number. From these normal vision, we can draw few of the conclusion about the integers. What are the key points which we have to keep in mind while solving the problem of integers? The first point is, every positive integer is greater than every negative integer. You can easily see from here, all the negative numbers are coming on the left hand side. As I have already told you, that the positive numbers are occurring on the right hand side. Since all the negative numbers are coming on the left hand side of all the positive numbers, hence the first conclusion can be drawn that every positive integer is greater than every negative integer. Now, the second conclusion is, every positive integer is greater than 0. Now see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all these are positive integers. Now since all these are positive integers and 0 is coming to the left of numbers, so we have said in the first only that the number which is coming to the left is smaller to that of the number which is coming to the right. So, every integer is greater, positive integer is greater than 0. So, all these are positive integers, they are coming to the right of 0. So, 0 is the smallest, then all the positive integers. Now, the third point. Every negative integer is less than 0. Again, with the very same concept which we have drawn for the positive integer, 0 is coming to the right of all the negative integers. Whatever bigger the number of negative integers, it is 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. But it is coming to the left of 0. Hence, 0 is greater than all of the negative integers. Now, another point is, suppose if you are taking two integers A and B, such that A is less than B. See here with the help of example, I am having two integers. I am having 1 and 2. This is A. This is A and this is B. So, we have taken two integers 1 and 2 such that 1 is less than 2. Now, when we are taking this to the right hand side of the number line, we are having A is less than B. Now, for this, the condition minus A is greater than minus B. So when we are considering the negative integers, means you are considering this as A and this as B. So what the condition happened? It get reversed. Here A is smaller than B. Why? Because 2 is coming to the right hand side and 1 is coming to the left hand side. Vice versa, when you are coming in this case, here minus 1 is coming to the right hand side and minus 2 is coming to the left hand side. So, the number which is appearing on the right hand side is greater than the number which is coming on the left hand side. So, minus 1 is greater than minus 2. So, this condition, this last condition for any two integers A and B such that A is less than B, then minus A is greater than minus B works out. Okay? Hope you all have understood the topic well. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you and have a nice day.